The cranial nerves are similar to your segmental nerves in that they have multiple modalities and they have specific targets, but the cranial nerves are all going to innervate structures in your head and your neck. They are motor, sensory, and they carry autonomics. What's a little bit different about the cranial nerves is that they can be segregated in that they may only carry one modality and not multiple modalities. And so here on our rubber brainstem, we can see almost all of the cranial nerves. We can see, we can't see cranial nerve 1 because that's olfactory and it doesn't attach to our brainstem, so it's not on our brainstem model. But we can see 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And again, they are going to innervate structures within the head and neck. They can be sensory, motor, or both, and some of them will even carry an autonomic component. So here are the cranial nerves: olfactory, optic, oculomotor, trochlear, trigeminal, abducens, facial, vestibulocochlear, glossopharyngeal, vagus, spinal accessory, and hypoglossal. And they are designated by Roman numerals 1 through 12. And most of the time, depending on who's your instructor and what they're expecting you to do, they'll accept either answer. They will accept either olfactory or cranial nerve 1 as an answer for a question involving that nerve. So as we mentioned at the beginning, the cranial nerves can either be multiple modalities or only single modalities. And so let me go through them step by step to talk about which one does what. The olfactory nerve is sensory and is responsible for your sense of smell. The optic nerve is also sensory and is how information gets from your retina back into your brain. The oculomotor nerve is motor, and it operates several of the muscles that move your eyeball around into the orbit. The trochlear is another motor nerve that innervates one specific extraocular muscle. The trigeminal nerve is mixed. It is responsible for the innervating the muscles of mastication, so the ones that allow you to chew, and it is also going to provide sensory information from your face and the inside of your oral cavity. The abducens nerve is motor, and it innervates one specific muscle, the lateral rectus. The facial nerve innervates the muscles of facial expression and carries one's special sensory modality. It carries taste to the anterior part of your tongue. The vestibulocochlear nerve is all sensory, and it's from your ear, both the cochlea, which is responsible for your sense of hearing, and the vestibular apparatus, which is responsible for your sense of balance. The glossopharyngeal nerve is mixed. It has an autonomic component, it has a sensory component, and it has a motor component. The vagus, again, is mixed. It has a sensory component and a large parasympathetic component, and we'll talk about that in a slides presentation all of its own. The spinal accessory nerve is motor, and it's motor to two specific muscles, the trapezius and the sternocleidomastoid muscle. And the hypoglossal nerve, the last one, is also only motor, and it is motor to the intrinsic and extrinsic muscles of the tongue. Now, you'll notice that these go in, you know, there's OOOTTAFVGVSH. If you look up online, you're going to see a million and one different mnemonic devices for remembering the order of the cranial nerves. When I was a first-year graduate student, I learned, on old Olympus towering top, a Finn and German viewed some hops. You know, I don't know. It worked for me. It has worked for me up to this point in my life. You will find your own mnemonic for remembering the order of the cranial nerves and what each one stands for. So what do I want you to know? I want you to know how many cranial nerves there are. I want you to know what their names are. I want you to know their numbers that go with the names, and then what modality. Are they sensory? Are they motor? Or do they carry both? If you know those things, then you're ready for the assessment.